people come to him, come to the way.
الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. سبحان الله. This today technology, this camera can see and record because of some lenses they have put together. It can see and can record. سمعنا وأطعنا. Listen and obey. اللهم ارزقنا علم اليقين عين اليقين حق اليقين علم اليقين. Audio comes to you like an audio. عين اليقين يعني knowledge of علم اليقين, knowledge of علم through hearing. If you don't hear you cannot know علم. عين اليقين is the certainty of knowledge through eyes, through مشاهدة. عين اليقين. So audio, vision, reality. With audio and with vision you have a complete picture. If you have audio alone you are only hearing. If you have only vision alone you can see but you cannot express. So combination of both will give you علم اليقين, عين اليقين, حق اليقين. Like the atom, the mass and the electron. If you take the mass, the atom stops, it's as an atom. You have the atom is a combination of mass and electron energy. Mass is the physical and energy is the electrons that goes around and protons. So everything depends on three. Number three is very important. It's better. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد. الله سبحانه وتعالى wants his servant to learn but he doesn't want him to from studying and learning to become a tyrant. What Allah said, وما أوتيتم من العلم إلا قليلا.
يعني ويسألونك عن الروح قل الروح من أمر ربي وما أوتيتم من العلم إلا قليلا.
They ask you about the soul because روح is, we know it's soul or an angel. That is being expressed about as an angel in Holy Quran. They ask you about ruh because Allah knows that the everything other than ruh can be known, but ruh cannot be known. They ask you about that means all knowledge that away from ruh that is not attached to ruh. It's nothing. The main knowledge is ar-ruh. Without ruh, everything becomes jamad.
Inanimous.
Inanimate. Yeah. Inanimate.
Inanimate.
Without ruh,
no movement.
no movement. Everything die. When the person die, is when the ruh left the body. So they ask you about ruh. Say to them, Ya Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَمَا أُوتِيتُم مِّنَ الْعِلْمِ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا. What you have been given of knowledge is a little bit. Today they say to you, technology, technology, physics, chemistry, stars, websites, everything. Still they are in limits. Allah kept knowledge of ruh in His hand. He gave what He wants to give to Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That's for Prophet. We don't know. But when someone dying in front of you, and you look at his mouth, what comes out? Can you see? Can you hear? No audio, no video, nothing, no one knows. Since we don't know, we must be careful and to prepare ourselves for that day. We are going to observe that day when the soul is coming out of our body through our mouth. People running and fighting, all Muslims around the world. What's the benefit? Everyone is running for dunya. All these conferences are being done for, still it is for dunya. It's okay. But it doesn't mean that you become arrogant and proud of yourself for a lecture that you give here and there. Allah said, وَمَا أُوتِيتُم مِّنَ الْعِلْمِ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا. Whatever you have been given from knowledge is very little. You know nothing means. Don't وَلَا تُزَكُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ. Don't praise yourself. You know nothing. وَمَا أُوتِيتُم مِّنَ الْعِلْمِ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا means you know nothing. You go to Library of Congress, how many books? Millions of books. What all of them touched on is one thing. To run after the truth, reality. علم اليقين, عين اليقين, حق اليقين, حق اليقين. The reality, certainty of reality. Every book is being written for something to teach you, to guide you, to direct you toward to find yourself or toward to find the community or to find the reality that is being veiled from everyone. Is not?
No.
All these books. And Sayyidina Ali, what he said? He said, all the books that has been written bring to the to waja'ul qalb.
Heartache.
There is nothing from it except heartache. You study, and what you achieve? Nothing, because more knowledge, new knowledge comes, the old knowledge goes. وَمَا أُوتِيتُم مِّنَ الْعِلْمِ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا. So Sayyidina Ali said to Sahaba, all these books, nothing comes from them except heartache. As Grand Sheikh mentioned that story. All of that is everything is based on one point. all of us, we have to focus on that point. That is the khulasa, the summary of all books. Summary of everything. And they said, Ya Ali, what is that? Tell us. He said, Ra'asul Hikmati, Makhafatullah. The head of wisdom. Everyone wants to be a wise man, is not? Everyone pretend and claim that he is a wise man. This camera can memorize everything and can repeat it hundreds of times whenever you want. The lecture can bring it up and doesn't say, I am a wise camera, wise man, self-sufficient, accepting everything. They move it left, it moves left. They move it right, it moves right. They fall, throw it on the floor, submitting, in complete submission. Be like that. You can hear, you can see, you can know the truth, the reality. Run for it. Fafirru ila Allah. That is what Islam. Islam is to run to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Run to Prophet Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Where Allah is telling us to run?
Allah.
Where is Allah telling us to run? وَلَوْ أَنَّهُمْ إِذْ ظَلَمُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ جَاءُوكَ. He didn't say, he said when they are oppressors to themselves, they come to you, Ya Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. Not to anyone else. When you are oppressor to yourself, no one wants to be oppressor to himself. But you might be oppressor to yourself by pretending that you know everything. And what you know is little bit, a drop. Allah is telling us, not Prophet, Allah is telling us. وَلَوْ أَنَّهُمْ إِذْ ظَلَمُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ. When they become oppressor to themselves, they run to you, Ya Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. المغارة المحمدية, the hidden Muhammadan cave. ففروا إلى الله, فأووا إلى الكهف. Run to the cave. فأووا إلى الكهف ينشر لكم ربكم من رحمته ويهيئ لكم من أمركم مرفقا.
فأووا إلى الكهف ينشر لكم ربكم من رحمته ويهيئ لكم من أمركم مرفقا.
Run to the cave, the Muhammadan cave. Allah will send on you His Rahmah. Who is His Rahmah? يَنْشُرُ عَلَيْكُمْ لَكُمْ مِنْ رَحْمَتِهِ وَيُهَيِّئْ لَكُمْ مِنْ أَمْرِكُمْ مِرْفَقًا. He send on you His mercy. Means you are running toward the cave of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. That mercy that with him is will be dressed on you. But run to him. أدب, أدب شيخ. أدب is to knock the door. وقت البيوت من أبوابها. Is that?
No.
وقت البيوت
من أبوابها.
وقت البيوت
من أبوابها.
من أبوابها. Come to homes through their doors. Don't jump from the stairs. Don't jump from the roof. Allah is saying, telling us, come to the door. Come to the house through the door. Means come to the reality through Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. He is the door. If Sayyidina Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم says about Sayyidina Ali, أنا مدينة العلم وعلي means the door. Ali is the door. Prophet is the مدينة العلم, the city of knowledge. Ali is the door. Allah, Prophet mentioned that Ali is my door. And Allah said, وَأْتُوا الْبُيُوتَ مِنْ أَبْوَابِهَا, come to the homes through their doors. The door of humanity is what?
Muhammad.
It's Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because Allah said, فَأْوُوا إِلَى الْكَهَفِ يَنْشُرْ لَكُمْ رَبُّكُمْ مِنْ رَحْمَتِهِ وَيُهَيَّ لَكُمْ مِنْ أَمْرِكُمْ مِرْفَقًا. He will sprinkle on you from His mercy, spread His mercy on you, and prepare for you a way. Yeah, a way that when you run to the cave, and in the cave you run, it has an opening, then it has a
exit.
It exit where? You are running in the Muhammadan wave, means you are asking Allah forgiveness and repentance, and asking Him to dress you from His rahmah that He said He will dress you in Holy Quran, Surah Al-Kahf, that we are mentioning. So you go from, you will exit on what? Pure there. Is not? You exit on what? What is the pure? Ihdina as-sirat al-mustaqim. Guide us to the
right path or straight path.
Guide us to Sirat al-Mustaqim. Who is Sirat al-Mustaqim? His Prophet, one of his name is As-Sirat al-Mustaqim. He is the Sirat. Because no one can go to paradise without Prophet Shafa'ah. He is Sirat al-Mustaqim, O Mu'min, O Muslim. فَأُوْ إِلَى الْكَهْفِ, He is the cave. When you enter His cave, you will be peaceful. Shaitan cannot approach you. You exit directly on the right path. That's why He said, when they are oppressor to themselves, they come to you, Ya Muhammad, they come to your cave. I made it like that. فَأْتُوا الْبُيُوتَ مِنْ أَبْوَابِهَا, go to the homes through their doors. You cannot go to homes through the windows. No adab. You will be thrown out. وَأْتُوا الْبُيُوتَ مِنْ أَبْوَابِهَا, Allah is telling, come through the door. You come through the door, I forgive you. That's why every amal to be accepted is by Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. And Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Allah addressed the secret of Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim to Prophet because he made Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim the key of
paradise.
Miftahul Jannah, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. The key of paradise is Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. How many letters in Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim? 19 letters. Ahlul Bayt, how many letters? 19 letters. Means the rahmah that Allah has secret, has put in Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, He addressed them to Ahlul Bayt through Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Means shafa'atul Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, or shafa'a anyone from Ahlul Bayt for you, you'll be granted paradise. A ticket to paradise. Keep them happy with you by mentioning their names.
Ameen.
By remembering them.
Ameen.
Sayyidina Rasulullah, Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Sayyidina Fatima al-Zahra, Sayyidina Ali, سيدنا الحسن والحسين أهل العبا. We are running in this dunya not knowing its beginning, not knowing its end. Awliya Allah, for them its beginning is zero, its end is zero, because it's not going to exist, it's going to disappear. يَوْمَ نَطْوِي السَّمَاءَ كَطَيِّ السَّجِلِّ لِلْكُتُبِ. The day when it comes, we fold heavens like we fold the books. They become, when you fold a book, it is between two covers. Everything is inside. This whole universe become folded like you fold the carpet or you fold the book. Means inside finish. That's why he said, وَمَا أُوتِيتُم مِّنَ الْعِلْمِ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا. What you have been given from knowledge is little bit. وَفَوْقَ كُلِّ ذِي عِلْمٍ عَلِيمٍ. Above every knower, there is a knower. Means you are nothing. وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهِ وَيُعَلِّمُكُمُ اللَّهِ. So he wants from you taqwa. He wants from us taqwa. That's why Sayyidina Ali said, Ra'sul Hikmah, the head of wisdom, is makhafatullah, is taqwa. Taqwa and takhaf Allah Azza wa Jal. To keep your heart always afraid from to be thrown in punishment. Today everyone speaks about forgiveness, forgiveness, forgiveness. Alhamdulillah, inshallah, we'll be forgiven.
Amen.
But to be forgiven, we have to have taqwa. Not to do what is wrong to be done, not accept it to be done, and then you say this is taqwa. No. Try as much as you can to keep taqwa in your heart. Shaitan will attack, but resist. And Allah will forgive you as He forgave Sayyidina Adam alayhi salam. Look, Sayyidina Habil, what he said to Qabil. لَإِنْ بَسَطَّ يَدَكَ لِإِنْ بَسَطَّ لِتَقْتُلَنِي مَا أَنَا بِبَاسِطٍ يَدِيَ إِلَيْكَ لِأَقْتُلَكَ.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لئن بسطت إلي يدك لتقتلني ما أنا بباسط يدي إليك لأقتلك إني أخاف الله رب العالمين.
مخافة الله. If you are extending your hand to kill me, I'm not extending my hand to kill you. Means Habil was able to kill Qabil. لَإِنْ بَسَطَ إِلَيَّ يَدَكَ لِتَقْتُلَنِي. If you extend your hand to kill me, مَا أَنَا بِبَاسِطٍ يَدِيَ إِلَيْكَ لِأَقْتُلَكَ. I'm not extending my hand to kill you. Means he was able to kill him. But he said, no, I'm surrendering. You want to kill? Kill. I'm going to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I am afraid. I fear him. مَخَافَةُ اللَّهِ, as Sayyidina Ali said. رأس الحكمة, the head of wisdom, مخافة الله, the son of Adam عليه السلام, 7,000 years ago, he said, I am not going to, because the Adam عليه السلام till now is 7,000 years. He said, I am not going to extend my hand to kill you. Today you speak with someone, he didn't like what you say, he will kill you. Is that? They go and shoot and make shootings in schools. For what? For shaitan. So awliya Allah, they know they are not going to achieve anything from this dunya because it's going to be folded. What they will achieve is akhirah. So people must not don't try to humiliate don't belittle people. Don't belittle people. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Holy Quran mentioned it many times. وَلَا يَخْتَبْ بَعْضُكُمْ بَعْضًا أَيُحِبُّ أَحَدُكُمْ أَنْ يَأْكُلَ لَحْمَ أَخِيهِ مَيْتًا فَكَرِهْتُمُ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اجْتَنِبُوا كَثِيرًا مِنَ الظَّنِّ إِنَّ بَعْضَ الظَّنِّ إِثْمٌ وَلَا تَجَسَّسُوا وَلَا يَخْتَبْ بَعْضُكُمْ بَعْضًا.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اجتنبوا كثيرا من الظن إن بعض الظن إثم ولا تجسسوا ولا يغتب بعضكم بعضا أيحب أحدكم أن يأكل لحم أخيه ميتا فكرهتموه واتقوا الله إن الله تواب رحيم.
Don't belittle your brother, your friend, your spouse, your husband, your children, your uncles, your aunties. Don't belittle people. Don't backbite as if you are eating a raw meat carcass. أيحب أحدكم أن يأكل لحم أخيه ميتان الله أكبر. Do you like to eat the flesh of your brother raw? Dead raw. Look the eloquency of bringing the issue of backbiting in one verse. أيحب أحدكم. Allah is asking, أَيُحِبُّ do you love to eat the flesh of your brother? Everyone eating the flesh of each other. They speak on each other. As soon as you go away, people begin to say, this one said this, this one has said that. Don't belittle your brothers. You see something wrong, try to mention it to him privately. And don't listen to people what they say to you without asking the other party, the second party. Many people, they throw others with buhtan,
false accusations.
in same tariqah, in same way, in same communities, between each other, Muslim against Muslim, mu'min against Muslim, against mu'min. False accusation. You did this, you did that, you did this, you did that. And for themselves, those who accuse the others, they think that they are pure. When you are accusing someone, you are not pure. When you don't listen from both sides, don't make your judgment. O Muslims, we are in a time, very difficult time. I was wondering, I'm saying 2 days ago, in New Jersey, I am thinking how possible this dunya going to continue with all what we are seeing of problems. No one can solve these problems. It's as Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has said, يَكْثُرُ الْهَرْجُ وَالْمَرْجُ. Too much killing is going to happen on earth. Too much ignorance going to happen. Not ignorance of technology, that doesn't mean anything, technology. What means really is behaviors. إِنَّمَا بُعِثْتُ لِأُتَمِّمَ مَكَارِمَ الْأَخْلَاقِ. إِنَّمَا For sure I have been sent to complete and perfect your manners. That is what is important. Means when someone speaks with you wrong, accusing you, you with the purity that you have achieved in your heart by being silent all the time, not entering into this backbiting, Allah will put in your mouth whenever you want to speak, He will give you a tongue that can speak heavenly way. And the hadith is very well known, famous. مَا زَالَ عَبْدِ يَتَقَرَّبُ إِلَيَّ بِالنَّوَافِلِ حَتَّى أُحِبُّ فَإِذَا أَحْبَبْتُ كُنْتُ سَمْعُهُ الَّذِي يَسْمَعُ بِهِ وَبَصَرُهُ الَّذِي يُبْصِرُ بِهِ وَلِسَانُهُ الَّذِي يَتَكَلَّمُ بِهِ. As long as my servant approaches me through voluntary worshipness, I will love him. When I love him, I will be his ears that he can hear with, his eyes that he can see with, his tongue that he can speak with. So when someone speaks in front of someone who has achieved that purity and Allah give him way to speak on his tongue, that person can carry all the bad smell from the people who is sitting with them, change their breath, which is dirty breath blended with all kind of bad manners. That wali can change all of that into a pure mouth and take away all this dirtiness. That's why when you give bay'ah to a guide, as Prophet ﷺ said, أَصْحَابِكَ النُّجُومِ بِأَيِّهِمْ اقْتَدَيْتُمْ اهْتَدَيْتُمْ. My Sahaba are like angels, like our stars. Anyone you follow, you will be guided with. Means guides are there, inheritors of Sahaba. When you follow a guide, he will take responsibility to clean you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us to these beautiful and sincere guides. And alhamdulillah, Allah guided us to Sayyidina Shaykh Sultan al-Awliya, Sayyidi Shaykh Abdullah al-Faiz al-Daghestani, Sayyidi Shaykh Muhammad Nazim al-Haqqani. May Allah keep us always on Sirat al-Mustaqim, on the way of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that Allah will forgive us when we go to the door and knock at the door, is going to say, Prophet, no, don't come. May Allah bless us. Ameen. And thank you for your coming. Ameen. And may Allah bless our brother and our son, Sheikh Nurjan, to what he is doing, a good job. Alhamdulillah, inshallah he can continue. Wa min Allah al-tawfiq bi hurmat al-fatiha. تقبل الله.
Love you. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday. No. He has to say it in Urdu.
Is it?
Yeah. Urdu.